And the bride.
With your legs.
We know we could talk you into it.
That's pretty funny. I don't know where to start. Tokyo, and you can live in a small three-room apartment, and you can pay the equivalent of $1,500 a month for it, but hell, in what way is that different from Manhattan? I mean, you know, we're willing to say Tokyo's our equals because they have the same insane, high-paced, fast city lifestyle that people along our East Coast like to indulge in. So, you know, yeah, I mean, we can probably duke with the Japanese and, like, you know, knock them out after three rounds because, after all, they eat rice and our fighters eat steak.
How about the Swiss Army wife?
The Swiss Army wife, yeah. You know what the Swiss Army wife does? She cleans your nails and she says, oh, they're so filthy. And, you know, the toothpick, it picks the... Don't do this in public, you know, as you're picking your teeth with a little toothpick in there. And there's a knife, and, you know, you're sitting there and you're whittling, and the Swiss Army wife says, why don't you go out and get a job instead of sitting around and whittling all day long? So that's the Swiss Army knife, or wife. So Terry, we gonna talk about the rich and the poor? Yeah, because, you know, let's talk about the poor, the deserving poor. Now what about the undeserving rich? The undeserving rich. They litter the streets with their Duff Bar wrappers. They clog our sewers with Evian water bottles. They don't work. They just sit around all day collecting interest on their huge swollen bank accounts, which they selfishly hoard up and don't share with anybody else. Every time I try to sleep in the automatic teller machine booth, they come in and they withdraw $20 bills and make a racket. Every time I try to sleep in the Goodwill Industries deposit box, they drop expensive clothing on my head. Can't get a decent... I'll tell you, those rich, they drive in a straight line. They don't let drunks wipe their windshields at red lights. They subscribe to newspapers. I'll tell you, there's no end to these guys. They drink imported wine. They actually have the nerve to dress up and smell good. Who do they think they are? And here's the worst thing. They maddeningly listen to soft music in the privacy of their own homes. My God, I mean, how undemocratic can you get? And they don't believe in God, they believe in the executive Jesus. Blessed are the pacemakers, for they will keep you young at heart. Blessed is Standard and Poor, but they shall inherit. And if a junior executive kisses your ass, be sure and turn the other cheek. I'd like to get those guys on the wheel of justice. You know, it'll be like the Wheel of Fortune, but instead of, or it'd be sort of like a cross between Judge Walker's People's Court and the Wheel of Fortune, you know? It's like, Donald Trump, for your self-aggrandizement, what should your punishment be? To live in Calcutta on $60 a year. Yay! You know. Actually, you could probably live pretty well in Calcutta for $60 a year. So, about as well as you could live in New York for $60,000 a year. Oh, man, I'll tell you. There are some things I can't figure out. Like, when you go home and you watch a video, what do you usually do? First thing, light up a joint, right? And, you know, you bring this video home and it's for your entertainment. But the first thing that flashes on the screen is FBI warning, you know, it just blows your high completely, you know. And I hate that when that happens. I sure do. You know, I hate that when you make it one of those stupid, irritating, repeated catchphrases that all comedians seem to use, you know. I hate it when that happens. You know, you get that little chirping sound to your voice that nobody north of the Mason-Dixon line knows how to do. You know, well, it sure is fun to see all you fine people out here today. You know, I was talking to my friend Earl. We were sitting around, you know what we were sitting around and doing? Well, we were drinking Early Times. It's his favorite drink. And Earl's old hound dog, Blue, was sitting there, and he was licking his balls. And I says to Earl, I says, gee, I sure wish I could do that. And Earl says, get to know him first. You know? Yes. I had this idea. Instead of, you know, all the fat jokes, all the cruel fat jokes that people tell, if you replace fat people with the sun, then it's just as funny, and also you don't go out of your way to offend fat people. So it's like, the sun is so fat you gotta dust it with flour and go for the wet spot, you know? Or, let's see, you're on trial for fucking the sun. My client is a midget. He couldn't have possibly fucked the sun. All right, not guilty. The judge goes up to the midget after the trial and says, just between you and me, I know you fucked the sun. How did you do it? He says, I threw a bucket over her head and swung from the handle. Yeah, jokes like that. But I don't know, though. I mean, some people might worship the sun, and that would get on their wrong side, too. So you just can't win. I want to ask you something. Every Valentine's Day, did you used to, like, get the little candy hearts that people give out on Valentine's Day, the little messages on them, and eat them, and start acting like the messages? You know, like you pop a lover's boy, and you go around kissing every woman in town. Or, you know, you pop a 23 Skidoo. Geez, you know, where do they get those messages anyway? What? This is something that somebody should write an entire book about. Valentine candies, their use and abuse. Yeah, you know, the CIA could start making it with messages like kill, you know, things like that. Assassinate foreign leaders, except you need to have really tiny print for that, and you need a magnifying glass to read it. I want to live in Connecticut, because Connecticut is sort of like living in Georgia. But, you know, people know how to shoot in Connecticut, and they're not drunk on moonshine, they're drunk on Graves, which is 200-proof grain alcohol, which is sold in stores. You know, they're just like Southerners in a lot of ways, except they're just a little more refined, you know. Pray, Maddie, don't whip that slave. You're disturbing my reading of Tacitus. I went to this place called the Class Warfare Shopping Mall. First I walked into Proletarians R Us, and the man at the counter said, I'm not paid enough to wait on you hand and foot. So I went over to the bourgeois hut, and the guy behind the counter said, go away, I can't wait on you now because I'm busy writing my novel, which is about three generations of my immigrant family. So I went to the rich store, and the man behind the counter took one look at me and said, where did you go to boarding school? So I got out of there. And I went next door to this place called the coffee shop, but it was closed. So I went next door, and there was this place next door called the coffee shop, but it was closed. So I went next door, and there was this place next door called the coffee shop, but it was closed. And I could keep this up all day, but I don't think I would. And then I went to this fortune teller, but her door was locked, and I pounded on the door. And she said, go away, I'm going to be robbed tomorrow. So I went to Timothy Leary's Crazy World of LSD. I picked up a couple of bargains. Got an Army Jeep for 17 cents. But the piece of lint set me back $1 million. So I didn't make out that well. Well, if our boys in the blues band are ready, I don't know who they are. Where the heck did they go? That's about a nice movie. Let's save them the trouble of going to the latest Dirty Harry movie. We'll do a Dirty Harry movie. It's called Go Wash Your Hands, They're Dirty, Harry. The prequel. Dirty Harry is 6 years old. He's a hall monitor in school. A bunch of tricycle hoodlums called Hex Angels are terrorizing the playground at recess time. And so the principal talks to Harry. He says, young Harry, I've called you into my office because we have a very serious problem that only you can help us with. These tricycle hoodlums have been terrorizing the school. I don't know what to do, Harry. Should we let him use the faculty lounge? And young Harry says, no, don't knuckle into these punks. They'll walk all over you with their fancy Keds and Adidas. The only thing these punks understand is a fistful of a roll of quarters right in their face. So he confronts the tricycle hoodlums and he says, You punks see this popsicle stick? This popsicle stick is the deadliest weapon known in the hands of a high school hall monitor. Now you might be asking yourself, is it sharp enough to puncture 9 of your tricycle tires, or is it only sharp enough to puncture 8? Now, before you decide, ask yourself this question. Did you rub your lucky troll today? Well, they decide to give him an assistant. Oh, swell, a lousy girl. She's gonna photograph your exploits for the high school newspaper, Harry. Swell. Well, come on, let's go to the cafeteria. I suppose you want some milk. Yes, Harry, that would be very nice. Can I have some milk? And he says, milk. Swell. And then out of the corner of his eye, he notices that the woman behind the counter serving up the lunch is getting very nervous. He notices 3 children wearing ski masks are about to start a food fight. So he gets a handful of mashed potatoes and he skillfully flicks it in each of their eyes without so much as putting his carton of milk down. And the girl says, oh, Harry, you're wonderful. Let's go out and get an ice cream soda. And Harry says, ice cream. Swell. Welcome to lovely Cambridge. We're about to start Mike the Spike's Blues Jam. Now we have a sign-up sheet right here, and if y'all would like to sign up and be a part of this Blues Jam, it's just waiting for you. Now, as I'm sure Mike's going to tell you, the boys in the band are going to do a set with their regular personnel, then they're going to start corralling all you Blues Jam individuals over here to do a show for them. I'm going to do what I do best. I'm going to go around and collect the money. And these boys are going to make it much less painful for you to give up that $2, because they're going to give you some fine, fine music in the intro. Let me welcome, please, Mike the Spike, his extraordinary, benevolent, beneficent, omnipotent blues jam.
Thank you, Francis. If you haven't seen Francis before, he was also, we call him our court jester down here because he kind of loosens things up for us here on the Saturday afternoons. We also were on Channel 55 Cable TV, Cambridge Cable TV, on Thursday night, where they had let us play a few songs and also featured Francis doing his shtick, as they call it, where he does dress up and all. I see a TV in the back. I'm not sure what they're doing, if they're filming again today. But my name is Mike the Spike, and I've got Terry Hughes on drums, my good friend Terry Hughes, who's in the process of getting his own vehicle. So in the meantime, we cramp all his drums and my guitar and amp into my little Honda. How we do it each week, it's we got down to a science now. And on bass is a good cat who's been, we've known each other for about a year, and he's come in to help us, Bucky Bear, on bass. That's it. And also stepping in to give us a helping hand on guitar, a young cat who I've known for a while, Mr. Tim Belanger, who was also brought his brother, who was a bass player, Warren Belanger, down here. So we're just gonna cut out here for a few moments of playing some blues, upbeat stuff, about four or five members. We'll keep it short, and we'll start to call up some of the jammers, some of the folks who come down to jam with the band. If you wish, we have a sign-up sheet, so we know who's here and what instrument you play. And we'll call you up accordingly. And if you feel gutsy enough to
say yes,
Please just let us know who you are. If you feel up to it, if you want to relax it back a while, check things out, feel it out. And if you get the nerve, or let me know what you want to sing or play. We can pretty much play just about, or play just about anything that you can come up with. So once again, welcome down here at the Saturday afternoon jam session at the Middle East Restaurant. We do this every Saturday from 3 to 6. And please keep coming on down to help support our efforts and certainly our skill. Becoming some top quality blues cats out of Boston. Without further ado, we'd like to break into a few things here that you will be recognizing. And just give us about 20 minutes of your time and we'll start calling you on that. Thank you. And while I'm thinking of it, we are doing something on the 23rd of May. And it's right down the street. It's on a Wednesday night. It's going to be the same thing down the Cantab Lounge. And that's where you learn, or at least where you see what they call soul. If you know what soul is, you'll certainly catch a glimpse of it down at the Cantab on the 23rd, which is a Wednesday night. We start at 9 o'clock with Bucky and Terry, and also probably bring Tim Blander in on this. So please, the 23rd of May, come down to the Cantab Lounge on Wednesday night. Thank you. That was by Chuck Berry, honestly, called Johnny Be Good. We're going to do another pickup song called You Know That, something, an original. We do play our originals once in a while, so we're going to cut out here with this one called You Know That.
Thank you.
kindly. Thank you very much. Once in a while, we like to feature some of the other cats in the band. We do like Terry, but he gets so carried away that he'll start dancing on his drum kit. So, but we're gonna try to talk Bucky into doing one for you, if you don't all mind. And from that laughter, I guess it's either a yes or a no. Bucky, he's cool. He's also into the country and western thing, is the way that I had pretty much had grown up when I was living in Oklahoma for about 3 years. And but they call it western music there. But Bucky can kick out the jams every once in a while, so we're gonna let him do one, if you all don't mind. Thank you. like to have fun.
That's a song I think that's what John Lincoln writes.
Like I said, we like to have fun, so we're gonna do two short ones. Then we'll start calling Southern Jazz. Again, if you haven't signed up, if you just got in, please do so. There's a sign-up sheet right here, and we'll start calling you up here in about 5 minutes. This one here, this next song, I was listening to Meg Cramer's Blues After Hours, and she's playing a little bit of Sonny Boy Williamson songs on the radio. So I'd like to do one here called Help Me. If You Could, by Sonny Boy Williamson. Thank you.
sit on. God to help me, child. Lord knows I can't do it by myself. And if you don't come and help me, I guess I'll have to do it all by myself. And you know that ain't too cool by me. Upbeat up here, we're gonna call up some of the folks here. This one is by Hi Tuffy. How you doing, brother? Living cool? we're gonna do a Robert Johnson tune called The Crossroads, real short version.
Go home. Robert Johnson. Many people have done it, including Cream with Eric Clapton and many, many scores of other folks. Right now, I'm going to turn this over to you folks. Thanks for coming down on this Saturday afternoon. Once again, my name is Mike Despite. We do this every Saturday from 3 to 6. We've got plenty of time, plenty of room for everybody. If you haven't signed up, please do so we know who's down here and we can get you on up here. Just give us about 2 minutes to break it on down and we'll get you on up here. Thank you. Harmonica he has, and we'll get him squared away so we can blow a little bit of the harp and take us back on down to the delta a little bit, I hope. Circle of fifths, okay, great. Okay. And we have blue guitar. I don't know if that's the gentleman's name or if that's the color of his guitar or not. Unless it's Bobby Bell, who I know his own has a blue guitar, but blue guitar, come on up. We have Warren Belanger on bass. We'll bring up Dan, Dangerous Dan on vocals, who's gonna sing a little bit of rockabilly style. We'll let him cut out a few numbers. And let's see, we have drums. We have Ken Lewis, who can play drums. Ken and I go back to our high school days. Before that, it was grade school for me, and before that, kindergarten, where I was still wearing diapers, I think.
You're blue.
Dan asked me to play guitar, but I haven't forgotten Zorky Warbaugh, who's a guitar player, who just pardoned me while I helped Dan out here. With Dan and I jammed quite a bit, so I kind of get the feel he feels more comfortable if you would just hold on, don't be assaulted or anything, or feel high enough. But once again, Dangerous Dan, Dan the Man, as we call him, he does a little bit of a rockabilly style. I think you'll enjoy it, so we're going to kick back and play some old hillbilly type style.
Thank you.
wound up. That's where my baby's head. I said there's a red house over yonder. That's where my baby's head. I ain't been home to my baby.
We're gonna let Dan do a couple more with the band, so while that time, I'm gonna enjoy my cold drink here, and we'll start calling some of the other folks. So once again, Dangerous Dan on vocals, ladies and gentlemen. Dangerous Dan.
Okay.
Give Dan a little break on the vocals. How about Dan? Dan, just Dan on vocals. And we're gonna keep Blue up on guitar here a little bit. And bring up here. Do you sing as well, brother? You want to sing a couple? Shorten that guitar strap a little bit. You can switch your guitar strap onto it if you wish. There's a guitar stand right back of you. Rest it till then. That's what he did, yes, on his Steinberg. Looks good. You break a B string? Alright, if you want to go ahead and switch it, I'll call some other folks here. Right now, we're going to call up Aaron on drums. Would you please put together for Ken Lewis? Keep Bob Mack on saxophone. We'll keep our harmonica player up here. We'll call up Honor to play bass. Would you please give a nice warm up for Warren Belanger on bass, who's been cutting his chops down here with this blues cast. Warren Belanger. And let's see. We have Bob on guitars. Bob in the house. Robert, guitar player. Come on up. And after this, we're going to bring up a young cat named Corky, who is also a guitar player. We'll figure out what he's up to. We'll cut some licks with him. And then after this, we'll start bringing up some more familiar faces. Okay, so how about it? Saturday afternoon, and I guess if they happen, we're into about our third month here, and without realizing it, they've been coming in. Some folks have been coming in from Channel 55, a local cable TV in Cambridge, and have been filming accordingly to some of the jam sessions down here, and we really didn't know anything about it, but they showed an excerpt from the jams on Channel 55 last Thursday night. And yeah, thank you. So I am now wearing sunglasses as I walk down the street because people are recognizing me and asking for autographs, which anyways, I'd like to give honor an honor. She has been celebrating her first anniversary of being married to Watermelon Slim, who's also a pretty cool cat around town. I think it's quite the thing. So we're always glad to have her in our midst and hanging out. She's gonna sing a very beautiful song here later on if I can convince her that she had written. It's a very slow blues and very, very pretty. Do we have,
You'll be right up.
Got a guitar player changing string. I guess I'll do one with on. Hang on, Chuck. And by that time, the cast will be ready. But I am still looking for Bob, whose guitar. I believe he might either be our bartender, or Bob might have stepped out to play his lucky numbers for tonight's Megabucks. So I'm not certain. So in the meantime, I'll play a number. By that time, we should be ready to roll me with the guitar players. Jazz drums, from what I understand, which is jazz, pretty, pretty cool. And are you all set, man? Okay, come on up. You all set. And this one here is called I Love My Baby, But I Do Love My Money Just a Little Bit More. Thank you.
that child, cause she's so, so cool. I love my baby. Just a little more.
Yeah, I love my baby, but I do love my baby.
We're going to do just a bit of a funky little jazz, I think, and maybe key of G to get this cat in the groove with this, make me feel a little comfortable walking down here at the Middle East restaurant.
We'll try something now. We have to keep up with you, man. So, I'm gonna try my best. Is that cool with you? A little bit of a swing style? Okay, the drums sound real cool.
This one, we're gonna do a little bit of Billy.
Yeah.
Maybe a little bit of Billy Holiday.
Yeah.
I'll have to improvise all the words, but we were hanging out, on the Thursday night at a place called Doc's Place over in the South End. And we caught a little bit of what they call being soulful.
What's that?
A place called Doc's, they have a jam every Thursday night, and it's a little bit different from what I've been used to.
White folks, look out.
Yeah, white folks, look out, because it is really
cool
place to be, and they treat us really nicely over there. But they turn us on to their own style of partying, which we thought we could party, but they show us how to do it the right way. Anyway, something here by Miss Billie Holiday. Just jam out on QG.
Look out. You knew
Most of the folks up here, one more time, is Bob, the guitar player here. I believe Bob is our bartender, still works about 5 o'clock, so I guess that's the way it runs. Okay, Corky, if you're ready, man, you come on up here. We'll figure out what we got going for you. It's the first time I've seen you, but come on up here, we'll figure it out, and we'll get you going here.
On a mailing list, if you'd all please put your names on it so we'll know who's here and when and why, that'll be right. I'm not swell, I'll be bringing you around shortly.
Start bringing up Chuckaluck and some of the other folks who have been waiting patiently. And let's see. As usual, things do get he's making you do. We also have a little surprise here before we bring up Chuckaluck and his crew to. Kind of knock the paint off the walls with their sheer energy. But Corky is getting set up here, and if you haven't noticed, Corky's my older brother. And
nice t-shirt, dude.
And I gave him that t-shirt one night. I was feeling kind of, as it says on it. And but right now we're going to feature blue guitar on guitar and vocals. Let them do two numbers or so. Call on some of the other folks here.
Listen, Mike, you tin horn. I know you have my pen. You have my pen. I want my pen back now.
I
give it back. You know what I get to be like when I get mad? Where's my pen?
It was here a second ago. I know I might drop it.
Well, if anybody would like to donate a pen for this sign-up sheet, then... I'm sorry, Mike.
I did find your pen, Francis, and it says a Holiday Inn on it.
I'm so glad you didn't try to go to Mexico with it. I would have had to hunt you down.
Well, I thought about saving that for all the autographs that I have to sign after the show is here.
Hey, it looks like Mike.
But once again, I guess, what is that pen when I saw? Matter of fact, that was on TV the other night. What, you were kicking the heck out of it, and you... once again, we do this every Saturday afternoon. We're going to let these cats seem like they're just about ready. But if you have not signed up, please do so, and we'll let you do your thing up here. We go right till 6 o'clock, and we have plenty of time to...
Can you hear that back from the monitors?
Not, no. Once again, we'll have a second here. We are doing something on the 23rd. It's on a Wednesday night this month. And it is at the Cambridge Decanter, which is right down the street on a Wednesday night. I guess the boys are ready to cook. Blue, can you do something? After Mother's Day, which is coming right up. My mother is coming up from South Carolina the day after. So it's gonna save me the expense of putting a stamp on an envelope, I guess. Although I've treated her fairly good. But, please listen to Mick Kramer's Blues After Hours on a Friday and Saturday evening from 10 o'clock till roughly 2 a.m. in the morning. It's great music to kind of sit and relax to. Kind of get your thoughts in order. So if you're with somebody, it's always good to have something like that on the radio. Kind of makes things feel very, very nicely warmed up. Says. Well, we're going to feature Blue on guitars first time. And normally we play in Quincy on Saturday nights down a place called O'Nally's, which we probably have something coming up shortly once again down there at O'Nally's Pub. We'll keep you posted on as far as future gigs. We do have something planned for live TV and also for live radio. Where you once again, Corky on guitar.